Hey y'all, Zack Glazer here, the legal tech advisor at Lawyerist, and I've got another quick product demo for you. This time, we'll be looking at MyCase. Specifically, we'll be digging into setting up their workflows and their case stages. Now, the workflows are essentially a series of connected tasks and meetings, and possibly even template documents that you can put onto a, or you can connect to a case that that is in existence. And they're basically just templates of tasks that you can do. But let me show you. So if we dig into one of the open cases that we have here, and we'll go to Kramer versus Kramer, and you can see the dashboard for the open case here, and there's a ton of information. But what we're concerned with right now is just this workflows right here. And so this workflows is going to affect our tasks, it's going to affect our calendar, and it could affect our documents. But we're going to drill down into there. And in order to apply a workflow to one of these cases, you simply click Apply a Workflow. So we choose a workflow. The only one we have right now is this client intake. And we're going to have to choose a retention date. And this retention date is really just the pivot date for all the other tasks. It's the date that the other tasks are going to be based off of. And you can call this date anything you want when you're setting up the workflow. But right now, because it's client intake, we do retention dates. We're going to do February 4th. And we're going to assign somebody to it and apply that workflow. And when that workflow is applied, you're going to see it here in this workflows section. And you're going to see what was done. So we have one task, prepared documents, two tasks, deadline to submit paperwork, and then three tasks, call client. And then we have a calendared meeting here, in-office discovery meeting. So those are all the things that were assigned to us. And we can go find those by looking at tasks within this and calendar within this case, or we could go to the tasks that we have broadly. And this tells us all the tasks we have all over our cases. Now, if we wanted to change those workflows or create a new workflow, because as you get into here, I'm sure that you would have other workflows that you want, you just simply go to Settings, Workflows, and then you can either edit the workflow by clicking on it and drilling into it, and then you can change things like the days, the priority, you can add or remove tasks, you can add or remove calendar events or change the calendar event, and you could add document templates to the workflow as well if you had document templates, which we don't have right now. But we're going to go back and we're going to add a workflow. So we're going to start at the beginning and we're going to call this Close the Case. And our trigger label is going to be case judgment date. Let's spell that like a normal human being. And we're going to add the workflow. And we can add tasks to this workflow. And so one of our tasks is going to be call the client. And we're going to do that one day after we get our case judgment date. So we're going to save that. Then we're going to add another task. And in this, we're going to do disengage client. And in here, we can add checklist items. That way, there are specific tasks within the task that way you don't have to put all the tiny tasks into the checklist or into the workflow. You can just put them in the checklist here. And since we're sending a final bill, we're going to make that high priority. We're going to make this due one weekday after the case judgment date. And we could actually make this based on the completion of another task, the call client upon update. We can make a no due date, or we could just trigger based on the trigger event. So we're going to save this. And you're going to see that we now have two tasks in this workflow. If we wanted to, we could create a calendar event for a meeting between everybody or a meeting with the client, or we could add documents to this workflow as well. So that's the quick, simple look at workflows in MyCase. And another aspect of MyCase that they have that some of the other law practice management systems may not have is multiple statuses for your cases. And they call these case stages. And when we're in settings, we just go over here to case stages. And you can see that right now we have discovery, in trial, and on hold, and we can assign those stages to any type of case that we have. But here in the settings, we can edit these stages, or we can edit their names, we can delete them, we can add new stages. So we'll add pre-discovery, move it up to the top, and then save changes here. And I'll show you where that affected things. So we go to this My Open Cases again. We go to Kramer versus Kramer, that case we were in earlier. And right here you see case stage discovery. And if I click on that pencil, I can change the case stage and we can go to the new one that we have, which is pre-discovery. And you'll see that the color over here in the case timeline changed. Because it keeps this case timeline keeps track of how long you've been in certain case stages, which can give you a 30,000 foot view of this case and help you determine whether or not you're bottlenecked or something like that. Anyway, you can have as many case stages as you want, and you can break these into, you know, anything that is appropriate for your file. So hopefully that was helpful and a decent look into the case stages and the workflows of MyCase. If you want more information, I'm sure MyCase would be happy to give you a demonstration. I know currently they have free trial accounts that you can use for a couple of weeks, and it might help you get a little bit more of a feel of what's in here. One of the things that I think is very interesting that you might want to look at is the chat function over here, which is very much like Slack built into MyCase. It is an interoffice communication portal.